So many people are getting help at the New Life Evangelistic Center, 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, Missouri. Don't miss this program. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. So many people getting help at 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, Missouri. Tell us your name.
Gwen Wilson.
And what kind of help are you getting here?
Well, I'm getting some meals, and there's a place to lay down to sleep when you're worn out and tired and you're walking a lot and unable to afford bus fare, et cetera, from going to doctors. Have, you know, caseworker that takes me to my doctor's appointments, so that's nice.
So they have, yeah, they have showers here, they have computers over here.
Showers here, computers here.
You can get a tree store here, library.
Yeah, a locker where you can put some of your possessions, which is nice to lighten your load.
When you're homeless like that, what does it mean?
Oh, wow. It's, I never thought I'd find myself in this position, you know, and it's a different life than people out there, I don't think, understand what it's really like. Your clothes get tattered and torn, so you guys offer a free store here. That's very nice, you know, because you just wear your clothes out, and I never knew that before I became homeless. So
well, let's go to Joe, the man that helps coordinate the New Life Evangelistic Center programs in Springfield, Missouri.
Hi, Joe Batson here at the Veterans Coming Home Center. I'm the manager down here in Springfield, Missouri. Basically, my job is to oversee the management of this property here. We're offering a lot of services at the vet center. We have showers. We have laundry, we have public restrooms, which is hard to find here in the Springfield area. We offer meals twice a day, except for Sunday, we just offer lunch. We encourage people to go to church on Sunday mornings. We have mail. People are allowed to send and receive mail from this address. We have a free store for homeless people. We have a day area for people to just come in, sit down, relax, get in out of the weather. We have locker space back here in the back. People are encouraged to lock their things up so they don't have to drag them around with them all day long. We have computers if people want to look for jobs, put in resumes, check their emails. We have a sleep area. It's in the very back of the building. A lot of times people are up all night walking around. They want to come in and lay down and rest a little bit. We encourage people to support the vets. We encourage people to support New Life Evangelistic Center. And we just want to thank you for your prayers and your generous gifts. Thank you.
I'm back with Gwen. And Gwen, how did you end up being homeless?
I ended up being homeless. I was a realtor for over 25 years. And the 2008 economy collapsed. And I went to go to a grocery job. And too much walking, was on my feet all day. I've got swelling really bad in my legs now.
You never thought this would happen to you?
Edema. I never thought this would happen to me. But I have faith. I'm a Christian, and I have faith. And I believe that God's got a will and a purpose and a plan for me.
How does this place here at 901 really help you?
It helps me in that it keeps me from being hungry. Keeps me from being hungry. It helps me because, you know, there are a lot of blessings in here that a person would not probably think coming in off of the street for the first time that are here. But there's a camaraderie here that I am really glad exists.
Right here, 801 North Jefferson in Springfield, Missouri, right?
Right, right.
And a lot of people are getting help because of those of you that are supporting the work of New Life Evangelistic Center, working to be there when people are hurting. You can pray for New Life. It urgently needs your prayers at this time. You can share online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. And also, you can give there at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org with your MasterCard, your Visa card, your American Express card, or you can send your gift right on in to P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. There's so many people getting help.
How you doing today? My name is Charles Cocking. I've been coming in to the veterans for over a year now, I'm going to say. I've been homeless about half my life, and right now I've got a little place, but it's just temporary kind of. I'm buddies with all these guys. They've treated me real good around here, I'll tell you that. And they give people free clothes here, free food. I think they're wonderful around here, I really do. Real nice people. And you've really done well with me, I'll tell you that right now. I've appreciated every second, you know, what you guys have done. And keep up the good work. I'm a buddy of Joe's, too. I don't know where Joe's at today, but he must be out to one of the other outfits, huh? You guys got other places that he goes and so forth. God bless y'all. You know, like I say, I've been there, done that, and seen it, and I was in the service, so not much scares me anymore, I don't guess. anyway, my name's Charles again, and I love y'all. Thank you very much. I appreciate what you've done, okay? I appreciate it. Thank you.
That was Charles, and I'm back with Gwen, right?
Right,
Gwen,
right.
You were indicating you'd been in real estate for 25 years.
Yes, sir, and been able to make a good living in real estate. And I had a series of losses. Uh-huh. I lost my mother, whom I uh-huh. loved dearly. Lost a house, lost a home, lost... my animals were my babies. Uh-huh. I never had children, so... loss after loss after loss, and it gets you into a chasm of depression that you're trying to crawl out of, but you need help. You need help to crawl out of that chasm and the anxieties that you experience out here on the street.
In order to use this former Social Security building here, mm-hmm. 801 North Jefferson, we went through a lot of battles. We had to battle the city, the county.
Right.
We had to battle the school district.
We thank
God that such a battle was done and engaged in, that Jesus provided the victory, because all these people would be out on the streets right
exactly.
now. Where would you go if it wasn't?
I wouldn't have a clue, Larry, where Reverend Rice, where I would go.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have a clue. With health issues and all that, I really don't know, have a clue. I don't have a clue.
And that's why,
all I can say, you know.
And that's why often we do. We have to engage in these battles, not because we want to, because rich and powerful folks don't want the homeless around. They want them out of sight and out of mind.
Yeah.
That's why we're in a major battle in St. Louis right now.
Right.
But we've got to keep believing God. I mean, God's
right.
children.
Well, I'll give you an example of people, with children.
Mm-hmm.
And I understand that everybody wants to have their children safe and sound. Mm-hmm. That's mm-hmm. the first thing on your heart. But when little children run from you because they see that you've got baggage or luggage, or you might not look the best that you've ever looked, or be real good and cleaned up, but you can come in here and take a shower, and get cleaned up. That kind of stings your heart. Mm. But
I
stay at safe to sleep.
Yeah.
At night,
mm-hmm.
it's a shelter for
mm-hmm.
women, and it's a good place for us to go mm-hmm. because we know we're going to be safe.
Right.
And they brought the little Girl Scouts in the other night, and that was that touched my heart more than anything, because they were just running around,
Amen.
You know, treating us like everybody else.
The discrimination against the homeless, it really
exactly.
hurts.
Exactly.
And these are, Jesus said, welcome the stranger. He said, as oft you done to the least of these, he said, even so you did it unto me. Remember the homeless Jesus. And one of the first people they meet when they come in here is Chester. He's at the front desk.
Right, right.
Check them in and
Chester
they try to see what helps
in.
They need.
Right.
Let's go to Chester.
I'm here at the VA Coming Home Center, Springfield, Missouri. I became homeless after I lost my job. I started here at Springfield about 2 months ago. My main job in Springfield is work the front desk, pass out the mail. We got showers, laundry, and also we have a phone. And also we have care items.
They fought for us, now we must fight for them. That's what your t-shirt says here, okay? And help the veterans at 806 North Jefferson in Springfield. So we're at the Veterans Coming Home Center. How important is this center to you?
It's very important to me. It's given me hope. It's given me challenge. It's given me a place. So now I can help out and volunteer and pay back to them.
You were homeless out on those streets like that.
Yes.
How did this place help you get off the streets?
It's just... been a true blessing. I mean, everybody takes up for everyone. Everybody looks out for everyone. It's like, it's amazing down here.
And if this place hadn't been here, what would you be doing all day long?
Who knows? We'd be out on the streets still. We wouldn't be here.
It's breaking the cycle of homelessness. That's what's happening, and that's what you make possible as you share with New Life Evangelistic Center. It's working to be there, and people are hurting. It's got a lot of creative programs. It's not beholden to the big money people or the power brokers, and the respect that if City Hall says jump, it jumps. No, it wants to help the homeless. City Hall in Springfield didn't want us to take this building, use it to help these people. They'd be out on the streets if we hadn't done that, and you hadn't been supporting New Life Evangelistic Center, so we could have done that. It's the same thing. The county didn't want them. Nobody wants the homeless around, but they're the people who are special to Heart of Jesus. When he said, fox have holes, birds have nests, he the Son of Man, and nowhere to lay his head. He's laid in a manger. He's a homeless child. Special. Yes, the homeless are to Jesus. And how does it know that, how does it make you feel to know that God loves you and Jesus, he identified with the problems of the homeless?
Oh, I mean, it's God's love is truly amazing. I mean, from where I've been at to where I'm at today, I couldn't have got through it without God.
And if you're on God's side, then you know what side he's on. And that's why we're asking to join us on that, partner with us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. In St. Louis, have the last emergency walk-in shelter for the homeless, the emergency room for the homeless. We're trying to fix up that emergency room. We're trying to continue to, in federal court, to guarantee that it'll be there for the people. So many people getting help, not only in St. Louis, but also in Springfield. And that's why we need your help right now. And your much-needed tax-deductible gift will make a big difference in the lives of so many people. It's P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. Yes, you can give online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org and know that you're making a big difference for good in the lives of so many hurting people, right?
Yes.
Some over here that are in crutches, wheelchairs, deaf people come in here, blind people come in, veterans hurting.
We just need a little bit more support for that ministry. Like if you know how to sign or if you know how to help with the disabled, please let us know.
Yes, we have many that come to the New Life Evangelistic Center. So many people getting help at this hour.
The VA here, I appreciate it being here because there's a lot of homeless people here in Springfield. I'm a ex-military person. I was a Green Beret for 12 years. As far as Memorial Day, that's what it's for, is for the veterans of the past. And keep up the good work. That's about all you can really do here in Springfield. I worked for the Victory Mission for 9.5 years after I got out, so I know how to deal with the homeless. And so just keep up the good work, Larry and Joe.
How does this place help you out?
Keeps me a little calmer. There are some glitches that could be ironed out, but you know, that's part of life.
Here, veterans coming home, they offer tools people can use that to their advantage, and with a computer, have a website, a phone to use to look into job interviews possibly, maintain hygiene, get some rest, food to eat, clothes. It's in mine's way I've always seen it as a stepping stone to try to get to where you're going. And there's a unity here amongst people like us. There's some that try and some that don't. But at one time here, I came here to Springfield approximately 3 years ago, and the city was in the process of trying to get the place shut down, and I had to the reporters in here and all, but it's still here. It's, maybe they got the message that places like this were shut down, and people that need this, where else would they go? There will be a congregation and it congregate elsewhere. This is Kansas City, city libraries. It just gives us an alternative. You know, with this, we don't have to go out and steal to maintain our hygiene and feed ourselves and all that. That it offers us something that in time we can offer ourselves as we utilize what this place is for. And I appreciate having a place like this around. met a lot of people here, a lot of staff that went and left, and no, it's not a bad place.
I've been homeless since July of 2012 because of my addiction issues, and since I've been coming here, I've been able to get off the alcohol and do pretty good about, you know, cigarettes and trying to get off the drugs and stuff like that. And for Memorial Day, I just want to thank everybody that gave their life for our country to help us. They didn't have to do that. It was something, you know, I believe that, you know, it was in their destiny to do, and, you know, it's a very honorable thing. And I also want to tell everybody Happy Mother's Day and all the mothers of the veterans, soldiers, and stuff like that.
This is about my fifth time at the VA, and I love it here. Wonderful people. They have showers. The shower facility, great food. I try to help out to get back to the organization for being here for us. I appreciate it. I don't know what I would do without them. I'm very thankful and grateful. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Nancy Pittington, and I am thankful that we have a resource such as the Veterans Coming Home Center. I'm on the streets right now. Unfortunately, my husband is a paranoid schizophrenic, and it comes rough sometimes. Joe and his staff here, they're wonderful. They will do whatever they can to help you to make sure that you have what they need. This place provides you with food to eat. It has a rest area. It has computers. You can do laundry. You can take showers. And basically, it's just a safe place to be so you don't have to be wandering the streets all day. I don't know what Springfield would do without this resource. We are blessed, truly, to have this place here. Thank you.
I've been coming to the VA here every day, Monday through Sunday. Pretty much they're open from 7 to 4. They help me out as far as, you know, staying out the conditions. They keep me cool. They feed me. They have plenty of activities. I mean, as far as computers go, to look for housing, jobs, they got plenty of resources. If you need clothing, I mean, they have numerous of everything. They're amazing.
My name's Gary Applegate, and my wife's Lori. I became homeless when I lost my house. They sold it about a month ago. And I'm a heart patient, and I just went through an operation 2 days ago, and I came to the Veterans Center here, and Joe helped me, and they gave me clothes and everything because I lost all my clothes and all that. If it wasn't for them, I'd be done in, you know what I mean? I'd probably be dead now, but you know, they've lifted me up. They've got me back on my feet a little bit, you know what I mean? They've gave me clothes, like I said. They feed me. They give me coffee every morning. And if I need any medical things, you know, Joe usually tells me what I can do or helps me out there, you know what I mean? I'm going through a lot medical-wise, but if it weren't for these people, I'd be lost. And I really want to express my appreciation for them and everybody here that helps us and helps every homeless person and veteran that comes in here. We love you.
Talking to Denise at this time, and Denise, how important is the Veterans Coming Home Center to you at this time?
It's very important. There's really no day shelter except for here. And
it meets a lot of needs?
It meets a lot
how
of needs
help you?
About just a basic food, access to computers, a safe place to be during the daytime.
That's important, particularly for a woman, isn't it?
Yeah, a lot of women have been battered and beaten up because of the situation of being homeless and not having a family to protect them.
I want you to hear from some more of our trainees as they explain some of the programs going on here.
Hi, my name is John. I work at the Veterans Coming Home Center. I help out in the kitchen. I do help prepare meals, set up for caterings, and clean up, and do a little bit of security on the side.
Hi, I'm Vince. I take care of the security during the day here at the Veterans Coming Home Center. At night, I patrol the grounds at 7 and 9 p.m. or thereabouts, letting people know that they need to find a place to stay for the evening. I close out my day about 10 o'clock and ready to go at 5 a.m. the next morning.
I'm back with Janice, and Janice, you were mentioning earlier, it's hard for anybody to be homeless, but particularly a woman.
Women are subjected to a lot of abuse by men. That's no other way to put it.
And
when they're homeless and they may be having alcohol or alcohol problems, no place to stay.
There aren't many places for people to go to get help, is there? I mean,
what
like
do you mean?
Well, like, for example, here you're getting the showers and meals and place to sit. You indicate it's the only day shelter the homeless can just walk into.
Right.
Walk in to get help. They are weary from being out on the streets. They got a place for them to rest over there.
Just to so you can focus on what you need to do and glorify God.
And that's what it is, to give people a chance to glorify God. Let your light so shine before men and women may see your good works and glorify your Father who's in heaven. What's so unique about New Life Evangelistic Center, gives people a hand up, not just a hand out. So many people working here were previously homeless themselves, and now they're helping other people.
Hello, I'm Susie. I'm a volunteer. I work here in the kitchen. I help serve food. I help clean up and just talk with the people out here. I was homeless myself, and I came back here to give back to what was given to me when I didn't have a home to live in. And I enjoy the people. I love working with everybody. I'm a people person, and this is why I want to be here, to serve. This is my family.
So this is one of the deaf ladies you're talking about that comes in here. And you're doing signing for, right?
Yes.
Okay. And what is your name?
It's Sherry, S-H-R-E, or S-H-E-R-R-I,
so
sorry.
So Sherry.
Yes.
And Sherry is homeless right now?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. How does this place help you, Sherry? How does it help?
She has lots of friends that come here. And they help her out a lot with a lot of stuff. So she's blessed to come here.
Amen. God bless you, sir.
They need a little more help with friends who can sign more for them. But all in all, she's very blessed to be here.
This is how the homeless are helping the homeless. And again, if you know sign, it's 806 North Jefferson here in Springfield, if you'd like to volunteer. I'm asking you also to pray for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center, as we want to help anyone and everyone who has nowhere to go. And the staff, people previously homeless, they'll tell you some more about what's going on here. And thank you again for being with us.
Bob. You're welcome.
God bless you. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Edward Miles. I'm from St. Louis, and I enjoyed the program to help people out, you know, because Larry Rice did it for me, so I want to help other people. I'm part-time security, part-time laundry, and part-time computers. And I'm learning a lot up here in Springfield and meeting new people and trying to help other people in the situation that I was in. And right now, I'm doing pretty good thanks to the program Larry Rice guy. Thank you.
What is your name?
Percy Nalen.
Percy, you're homeless. You're coming to here. I see you got a few things out of the free store here.
Yes, sir.
And what's the hardest thing about being homeless and in a wheelchair?
Not knowing where you're going to lay your head at next.
How important is this place to you?
Very important, because it gives you somewhere to come.
Does it really?
Yes, sir, and especially to get in and out the rain like the weather was.
Wow. So what would you do if it wasn't open here?
Hide up, get up under a tree.
Wow, that's pretty hard, particularly when you're in a wheelchair like that, trying to move around.
Yes, sir, and I would hate to end up like those cows that was on the news, too. That was up under that tree too close, and the lightning struck, and they all was killed.
You ever think about things like that?
Yes, all the time.
Shouldn't have to huddle under a tree in a wheelchair. And yet that's how our homeless people are treated, whether it's in Springfield, St. Louis County, where there's no real walk-in shelters and they're on the go constantly, over in Illinois. So many people hurting. And that's why we at the New Life Evangelistic Center have to keep our doors open and keep doing what Jesus told us to do. We have to. And, you know, we're not one of these organizations that have been totally castigated by some rusty razor blade by the power brokers taken over because they want to filter the federal money through them like they do in these communities through the St. Louis Continued Care and others. No, New Life Evangelistic Center goes directly to caring people like you who are willing to directly share. So whether it's in Springfield, Missouri, St. Louis, Missouri, a host of other locations, we can be there when people are hurting, whether they're deaf, whether they're in wheelchairs, that they can be there. I see you got some clothes out of the free store.
Oh, yes, sir. A pair of house shoes, a pair of underwears, and a pair of socks, and something to sleep in.
Oh, wow. So that makes a big difference.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Something clean to put on. Yes, sir. My mother always told me that you may be homeless or you may be on the streets or whatever. It's a hard time, but you don't have to go looking like that.
And in the middle of it all, you can know that God loves you and He's got a place for you, right?
Yes, sir. And He provides places like this here. And I would just like to say in the closing, He said, when I was hungry, you didn't feed me. When I was naked, you didn't clothe me. When I was sick, you didn't come visit me. When I was in prison, you didn't come. Yeah. He said, Father, when we ever saw you like this, Lord, He said, when you've done it to the least one of mine, you've done it to me also.
And that's why we encourage you to get involved in the Greater St. Louis Homeless Jesus Fund. Go to www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. Learn all about it. Or join me as I reach out through caring volunteers to make a difference, whether it's in Springfield, St. Louis, or wherever. Let's let the light and love of Jesus flow through each one of us. That opportunity is available to you. For further information, call 314-881-3218. 314-881-3218. There's opportunities in St. Louis, there's opportunities in Springfield, there's opportunities for you to make such a big difference. I want you to hear from some more of the staff as they tell you about what's happening. Yes, at the New Life Evangelistic Center, Veterans Coming Home Center in Springfield.
Good morning. This is Stan Walker down at the Springfield, the Veterans Coming Home Center. My job is to help people on the computer in the locker room in the rest area.
It's not just the deaf, those in wheelchairs, but the mamas and little babies that also come to the New Life Evangelistic Center. 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, Missouri. What's his name?
David.
How important is this place open for you and David?
Very. It gives us a place to go in the daytime, especially when it's raining or it's too hot for him.
Wow. So, yes, New Life Evangelistic Center in Springfield, Missouri. Took the former Social Security building here, is using it day after day, helping hundreds and hundreds of people. A lot of people come through here, isn't it?
Yeah.
And we don't want to leave little David out on the street, do we?
No.
Well, will you please help little David and so many others by sharing your much-needed gift now with New Life Evangelistic Center? Your tax-deductible gift is urgently needed now in so many areas at the New Life Evangelistic Center. P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. We just want to say thank you on behalf of David and everybody, right?
Thank you, yeah.
Yes, God bless you. Hi, David. How old is he?
4 months.
4 months old. It's hard not having a place and being on the street with 4-month-old David, right?
Mm-hmm. So very hard.
So when you come in here, you got a place to stay, you got food.
Yes, mm-hmm. It's great food.
And you meet a lot of other people that are going through similar situations, build friendships.
Yeah, and get a lot of advice from people. And know help and get a lot of advice.
And know that you're not alone, right?
Mm-hmm.
Amen. He don't want to turn loose, does he? Look at that. He's got quite a grip there. And we want you to grab on and hold on, helping the hurting, helping the homeless, reaching out through the love of Jesus. Oh, your gift makes such a big difference. That New Life Evangelistic Center, touching, hurting, and homeless people who have literally nowhere else to go in so many different ways. Please pray, care, and share now. If you'd like to volunteer, call 314-881-3218. Get information about the Greater St. Louis Homeless Jesus Fund. And help New Life Evangelistic Center to continue to be there when people are hurting, whether it's in Springfield, Missouri, St. Louis, Missouri, or a host of other locations. Go to www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org and please send your much-needed tax-deductible gift now to P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. Thank you for caring and sharing.